This is our third box of Thor Ragnarok. You might remember that our last box was a hot box, which had a hit in every pack. I've never had that happen to me in the history of the hobby. That was a really unique and fun experience. I would be content with one big, huge hit out of this box in the form of a Chris Hemsworth autograph to give away. That's what we're shooting for. But look for actor autographs, movie memorabilia, original art sketch cards, and premium insert cards. Three hits per box on average. 15 packs, four cards per pack.
And it will be hard to top that last one, Rob, because it was so much fun. It was fun to be able to give away multiple Dyson Rip cards.
It just kept coming.
That said, we may not have that same luck of a box, but all it takes is one as well. And there's also dual actor autographs, as well as the Grandmaster's Prized Possessions actor autos with strands of chain embedded in the card. So we could get something really cool if we had that. And now, so I was going to ask you a question, but then I figured I can figure this one out myself. So if you don't know already, our website is gogts.net. So it's just like the show, except the show is GoGTS Live. And on the website, we have checklists. So if you have a question like, hey, is Mark Ruffalo in this product? Does he have autographs in this product? You can go onto the checklist. You can control F from your PC, or I don't know what you do on a Mac. I guess you just like think and it does it for you. You can search and find out the sad news that there are no Mark Ruffalo autographs. But you can know with certainty because GoGTS.net provides you that information.
That's right.
And we've got some great blogs out there, too, that have been seeing a lot of traffic now with all the excitement in the hobby over spring training and NBA playoffs coming up. And lots of really good stuff on the blog. Oh, that's a good-looking Chris Hemsworth card.
Behind the scenes? Look at that. That's awesome. I've always been a fan of...
Carl Urban in this, as that the guy there, the evil guard guy, he was underrated. He did a good job.
I agree. I thought her role was great, too.
Is that Tessa Thompson?
Yeah.
Yeah, she killed it.
You getting geared up for Infinity Wars? You ready to see Thanos?
I am. How great was that last trailer?
I know. How great is the latest movie poster? Is that like a record for the number of superhero characters fit on one poster?
Yeah, it's crazy. I'm actually very lucky. Well, I don't know. It's not even any, but it's just fun. My buddy does the trailers for the Marvel movies. I don't get to see him early or anything, but it's just always fun because I see them specifically because it's his post in the feed saying, hey, guys, we just launched this. And that's always kind of fun.
That is cool. Like he does the editing to put them together and make them the official trailer.
Yeah, he's with the editing house that has had the Disney contract for the entire Marvel run or the Marvel contract for their entire run. So, and he's the lead guy there. So
look at how
just
great.
One of those
look
fun
at
things.
Look at the design of this card. Look at the, is that a parallel? No, it's just an insert. What is this called? It's hard to read in that foil.
But it is cool. Maybe,
Oh, wait, I have glasses. Hold on a second.
LTFX parallel, blue LTFX
Mistress
parallel.
Of Death, MD. MD5, Mistress of Death.
Okay. Well, Apple F that.
Apple F that? What?
That's what James said, the asset. He said, Apple F is how you search on a computer, on an Apple computer. I just thought that all you had to do was just, like, speak to it. I still feel about computers like Scotty does in Star Trek IV, The Voyage Home. When he sits down and he's like, hello, computer, and the computer does nothing. It's like, what's going on? And then the guy says, use the keyboard. And so he goes, hello, computer. So I say as my keyboard moves all around, so no matter where it goes, you can hear it. Sorry about that.
All right.
We're working on it, okay? One fix at a time.
So there should be, what, two or three hits in here, and we're down to three packs. So we're going to find out either if that was a hot box or if there's collation issues with this product. And guess what? There is no hit in this pack.
Well, what defines a hit, Rob? Don't forget that. We still have that poll up on twitter.com/GoGTSLive.
Guess what? We have one pack left, and we haven't gotten a hit yet. So maybe that wasn't a hot box. Maybe we stole all the hits out of this and somebody else's box.
Yeah.
Hold on. Come on. Is there a hit
in here?
Well,
to be fair, at least we got one of the dud boxes then, too.
Wow. I guess that is fair. Because out of this box, not only did we not get a Chris Helmsworth autograph, we got absolutely zero hits. So apparently, Thor Ragnarok had some collation issues. And given the fact that I've seen how this is produced or how those cards get, I can only imagine that that feeder machine went down while the rest of the line kept going before they caught it. Now, the question is, okay, if they caught it, wouldn't they have known that X number of boxes went out without having hits in it? And why wasn't X number brought back to the line and redone? So it's
someone was on their lunch break.
Yeah, I think somebody was on their lunch break. But have no fear.
When we say that,
have no fear, because I knew I kept this from the Upper Deck conference for a reason. I have a one of one sketch card that Chris Carlin pulled out of a pack at the conference and gave me. So,
not a black and white sketch card. That is a full
not to go away empty handed. We have this beautiful one of one sketch card.
And again, Rob, if it had to happen to anyone, I'm glad it happened to us. We got to see that amazing photography one more time. And it was our third box.
It was.
So and we've been spoiled.
You did bring up a great point, too, is that I'm glad that we got one of the dud boxes as well. Because we certainly made
more
than made
up. But, Rob, they send us loaded boxes to promote the product.
Oh, yeah. Okay.